My name is Julian Fleron. I'm a professor of mathematics at Westfield State. Last fall, I taught a course for students who typically didn't want to be in a math course. It's a core course where we talked about perspective drawing, perception, how to render 3D things in 2D, about the fourth dimension, and thinking about what different ways of visualizing things gave you different perspectives about what we were looking at. And while we were working on that one day, I brought in these big pieces of art, of two-dimensional art. One of them looks like a typical Necker cube, and one of them looked very similar to that, except for it looked like a longer stretched out box. Another one looked even longer, and another one looked even longer. If you put yourself in the right position, all of those things look exactly like a cube. And the students were amazed at this, even though we'd been talking about perception all semester. When the spring came around, there were a few students who wanted to continue this and do it as an independent study project. And so I worked with two students in particular, Summer Walker and Ainsley MacLeod. This piece of art, in one perspective, has words of hatred and bigotry and homophobia and sexism, other kinds of intolerance. And on the other side, it has words of hope and tolerance and peace and brotherhood and unity. And so as you go past this, you see two completely different perspectives of the world. And we chose as our centerpiece about 2,000 pictures of Westfield State students and faculty and staff. So what you have is you have humanity centered between the poles of tolerance and unity and bigotry and intolerance. And the goal of the piece is to get people to think, which side are you on? Where are you standing? Does your perspective inform how you think about certain issues, about how you see the world? There's a lot of people who say that they're not good at math, who say that they don't like it. In particular, in this class where we have a lot of students like that, it's wonderful to see them overcome this, to see that mathematics is something completely different than what they thought it was. When we unveiled this thing, it was really a powerful thing for the students who finished the piece, but also many of the students who had kind of designed their own pieces in the fall and who had thought about this project hard, to see that in reality, this thing had happened. This was a mathematical statement about intolerance, and I think that that was really uplifting and empowering to the students and me.